Now let's see about overloaded constructor in C sharp, or we can also call it as constructor overloading in C sharp. We know what is overloading. Overloading means using the same thing for different purposes. So method overloading means using the same method for different purposes by providing different number of arguments. Okay. So likewise, constructor overloading means using the same constructor for different purposes by providing different number of arguments. That means using the same constructor for different purposes with different signatures. Let the first constructor may contain one argument, second constructor may contain two arguments, third constructor may contain zero arguments, fourth constructor contains seven arguments, likewise. Okay, so giving the same name to the constructor with different number of arguments. So let's see this example. Here we have two classes. The first class is room, whereas the second class is test. Okay, here we have two instance variables, length and breadth, and here we have a constructor public room of int l comma int b. So next we are performing initializations. So length is equal to l, breadth is equal to b. So here the first constructor contains how many arguments? Two integer arguments. Okay, so if we pass two integer arguments while creating an object, then this constructor will be called. Okay, now let's see the second constructor. So public room of int l. Okay, so the second constructor contains only one integer argument. Okay, so next, initializations, length is equal to l, breadth is equal to l. Okay, length is equal to l, breadth is equal to l. Okay, next, area method, we are displaying the area by calculating the area. So console.writeLine, area is plus of length into breadth, length into breadth. So that is nothing but the formula for area here. Next, we know that execution of the program starts from the main method. So here, let name of the class is test. We know that execution of a program starts from the main method. Next, an object is created. Room obj1 is equal to new room of 10 comma 20. So this is nothing but a constructor. So whenever an object is created, then the corresponding constructor is called. So here, what are the arguments here? So 10 is the first argument, 20 is the second argument. So the constructor which is having two integer values will be accepted. Okay, so 10 will be passed to L, 20 will be passed to B. Okay, so now length value is 10, breadth value is 20. So length value 10, breadth value 20. Okay, next obj1.area. So control goes to the area method. Next, area is plus of length into breadth. So what is the output now? Area is equal to, area is, so 10 into 20, that is nothing but 200. So 200 will be printed on the monitor. Okay, next, this method execution was over, so control goes to the main method. So what is the next statement? Room obj2 is equal to new room of 10. So now what will happen? A constructor which contains only one integer value will be accepted now. Okay, so whenever this object is created, then the control goes to the constructor which accepts only one integer value. So this is that constructor which accepts only one integer value. So L value is 10 now. So now length will become 10, breadth will become 10. So length 10, breadth 10. Okay, so constructor execution was over. So control goes to the main method. So the next statement is obj2.area. So control goes to the area method. So area is, so in obj2, so what is length value and breadth value? 10. So 10 into 10 means 100. So 100 is displayed. Okay, next, this method execution was over, so control goes to the main method. So there is no statement after this statement. So this is about overloaded constructor or constructor overloading in C sharp. Okay.